Hey everybody, this is Fadi and welcome again to another episode of How to Build and Maintain a Reef Aquarium. Today, I speak about the cleanup crew. Cleanup crew are some kind of invertebrates that will consume uneaten food, detritus, and different kinds of algae. Each of these invertebrates has a different function. And in this video, I'll talk about the different kinds of snails, crabs, shrimps, sea stars, and urchins, and their role in the aquarium cleanup crew. There is something very important to know, that the cleanup crew is not the main method for cleaning and removing algae from your tank. They are just a small part of the entire nutrients and algae control in your tank. Combined with filtration, proper feeding, and regular maintenance, including water changes and cleaning. Don't start with a large number of snails and hermit crabs. You need to make sure that there will be enough food for everyone. If there isn't enough food, hermit crab will start attacking snails and eating them, in addition to attack each other, until eventually starving to death. You can start with one snail or one hermit crab per 10 gallons of aquarium water. You can add more later as fish population increase and bioload increases. Snails will feed on the algae that grows on the rocks, sand, and aquarium glass. Banded tortoise snails are a great addition for your reef aquarium. They help control diatoms and algae that will grow on the aquarium glass, in addition to grazing on algae growing on the rocks. Nursery snails spend most of the day inside the sand bed and will come out of the sand when the lights are off. They will keep stirring the sand, searching for uneaten food. So it's better to add them later after adding few fish, so that these snails can find something to eat. And they need deep enough sand bed for them to hide. The turbo snails are an excellent member of your tank cleanup crew, since it quickly consume large amounts of nuisance algae, especially hair algae, and will consume mass quantities of algae from the live rock and aquarium glass. Some reef aquarists prefer to keep turbo snails in aquarium with well-secured rockware, as it is known for turbo snails to bulldoze loose rocks while searching for food. The emerald crab has a bright green body with hairy legs. These crabs will eat nuisance algae, especially bubble algae, in addition to scavenging leftover food. However, emerald crabs can outgrow your tank. If food is not available, they may turn to eat corals and invertebrates. Hermit crabs are fun to watch as they move around your tank. They will pick up detritus from the sand and rockwork and graze at algae along the way. However, hermit crabs will often pick on snails either to eat them or to steal their shell. So it's better to add extra empty shells from different sizes. There are many types of hermit crabs, like scarlet reef hermit crab, Halloween hermit crab, and blue leg hermit crab. The acro crab is a small crustacean which lives its whole life within the branches of Cuscinipora and Acropora corals, keeping the area between the branches clean. Until recently, it was considered by some aquarists to be a pest. Actually, the acro crab is considered very good for your coral and will increase success with keeping SPS corals, especially it will clean between coral branches and will defend the corals from some pets like Acropora eating flatworm. There are two main types of shrimps that we keep in our aquarium, cleaners and scavengers. Cleaner shrimps will pick parasites from the fish body, while scavenger shrimps will eat leftover food. The skunk cleaner shrimp is a very popular addition to the reef aquarium and will set up a cleaning station in your tank and wait for fish to come and be cleaned of parasites or dead tissue. The cleaner shrimp requires peaceful tank mates. Some fish, such as hawkfish and lionfish, may see the shrimp as food. The fire shrimp, another popular shrimp for the aquarium hobby, prefers a cave or overhang where the light is not too intense. Similar to skunk cleaner shrimp, it will set up a cleaning station to clean fish from parasites and dead tissue. The banded coral shrimp or boxing shrimp is named so because of the large pinchers on its third set of legs. These pinchers give the banded coral shrimp the appearance of a boxer ready to fight. The banded coral shrimp can be aggressive toward other coral banded shrimps and smaller shrimp from other species. However, most of them are peaceful towards fish, corals, and other invertebrates. It's recommended to keep one boxer shrimp in the reef aquarium or keep them as a mated pair. And this shrimp is a scavenger and will eat uneaten food. The peppermint shrimp is best known for its natural ability to manage aptasia. Keep in mind that some individual peppermint shrimp are better at managing aptasia than others that may not be interested in aptasia at all. This shrimp is a scavenger and will consume uneaten food and detritus. Sea stars or starfish can sift through the sand, clean algae from rocks, and grazes across the aquarium glass feeding on algae and dye. The sand-sifting starfish will consume detritus and uneaten food. This sea star burrows himself in the sand in search of food, sifting detritus and aerating the sand bit. Make sure to feed your sea star enough food so it doesn't burrow in the sand and starve to death. Sea urchins are excellent algae grazers, keeping corals and aquarium glass clear of unwanted pest algae. Their spines protect them from fish and other predators. However, they may knock down some rocks and corals. Some are the short spine urchin, tuxedo urchin, and the black long spine urchin. The black long spine urchin are excellent algae controllers and are known to consume different algae, including peropsis. There are some kind of fish that can be considered as a part of the cleanup crew. Tanks are aggressive algae eaters and will constantly pick algae from the rocks. Some examples are yellow tank, purple tank, and collie tank. Foxface is known in controlling algae, especially purple algae. Sand-sifting guppies like diamond guppy will make sure that sand's clean. However, they usually bury corals that are placed directly over the sand. It's better to add all sand-sifting animals like guppies and starfish when the tank is more established and the sand has some nutrients and microfauna that can support these animals. Cleanup crew are sensitive to changes in parameters such as temperature, salinity, and pH. So proper acclimation is needed so they do well in the new tank environment. Drip acclimation is done by slowly dripping water from the main tank to a bag or container for around half an hour until the temperature, pH, and salinity of the container water matches the value in the display tank. I use this innovative marine drip to drip water from the main tank to the acclimation container, and I usually check the temperature, salinity, and the pH of both water. The more difference in value, the more time for acclimation is needed. If you are dealing with a huge algae outbreak, you need to figure out the main reason and cause, like non-functioning equipment, not enough filtration, bad feeding practices, or not ideal source water that contain high levels of nitrate and phosphate and silicate. After solving all these issues, you need to manually remove all algae and do a 30% water change and try to siphon all algae during making the water change. Keeping the algae in the tank will feed the cleanup crew. That waste will eventually break down to nutrients and nitrate and phosphate that will feed more algae. Even if the algae is not eaten, also it will decompose and break down to more nitrate and phosphate. By manual removal and siphoning as much algae as you can, we are exporting the nutrients out of the tank. That's it for today. In the next video, I'll talk about aquarium lights. Thanks for watching and see you soon in the next episode, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.